In this lecture, we will discuss about the concept of co-channel interference reduction factor. So reusing an identical frequency channel in different cells is limited by co-channel interference between cells. And the co-channel interference is thus becoming a major problem. What are the co-channel cells? The cells which are using the same frequencies are called as co-channel interference, are called as co-channel cells. And the interference caused by usage of these two, by uses of the channels which are using the same frequency are called as, is called as co-channel interference between the cells. And while designing a system, it is a major problem and we have to look after when we are repeating the same frequency, at what distance we have to use, and we have to take care such that the interference, the co-channel interference should not occur, and we have to minimize the co-channel interference. So here we would like to find the minimum frequency reuse distance in order to reduce the co-channel interference that is occurred. So assume that the size of all cells is roughly the same. The cell size is determined by the coverage area of the signal strength in each cell. As long as the cell size is fixed, co-channel interference is independent of the transmitted power of each cell. It means that the threshold level, the received threshold level of the mobile unit is adjusted to the size of the cell. So actually co-channel interference is a function of parameter Q, defined as Q is equal to D by R, where D is the distance between two co-channel cells which are using the same frequency, and capital R is the radius of the cell coverage. So the parameter Q is the co-channel interference reduction factor. So when the ratio Q increases, automatically as Q is equal to D by R, co-channel interference also decreases, because the distance between the two co-channel cells will increase. When the distance between two co-channel cells increases, the co-channel interference automatically decreases. Furthermore, the separation D, as given in equation 1, it is a function of, that is, the distance is nothing but separation between two co-channel cells. So it is depending upon, it is a function of Ki and C by I, where Ki is the number of co-channel interference cells in the first tier, and C by I is the received carrier to interference ratio and the desired mobile receiver. So what is this first tier, second tier? I will show you in the next figure. So here Ki, the distance D between two co-channel cells is depending on, it is a function of Ki, that is number of co-channel interference cells in the first tier. And C by A is the received carrier to interference ratio or the desired mobile receiver. The formula for received carrier to interference ratio is C by I is equal to C by I. Here the interference, here I is nothing but, it is the interference caused by the number of cells in the first tier. So it depends upon the, if it is 6, it is 7. So how many number of cells are there in the first tier? The summation of all the cells, the interference of the summation of all the cells will be taken as the total interference. Okay, we'll see in the next slide clearly. So in a fully equipped hexagonal shaped cellular system, there are always 6 co-channel interference cells in the first tier. You can see here, this is the cell 1. For this cell 1, this is the first tier we are calling. And this is the second tier, and this is the third tier. That is, this is a cell, and how many number of cells are covering this cell? Those are come under the first tier at a distance of some d, and that is each cell is having a radius r. And again, the other cell, this is some distance is maintained, that is second tier. So depending upon the distance, we are calling a second, third, fourth, and third tier. You can see here, if you take the cell 1, so how many number of cells are there in the first tier? So we are having 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 cells we are having. So here it is Ki, which is a function of, as a D is a function of Ki. So here how many number of cells are there in the first tier, that is which comes under the co-channel interference cells, are there always in the hexagonal shaped cellular system 6 co-channel interference cells in the first tier, as I have shown in the figure. So the maximum number of Ki in the first tier can be shown as 6, that is 2 pi d by d is equal to 6. So co-channel interference can be experienced both at the cell site and also at the mobile unit in the center cell. If the interference is much greater, then the carrier to interference ratio of the mobile units caused by the 6 interfering sites on the average, the same as the C by I received at the center cell site caused by the interfering mobile units in the 6 cells. Okay. So According to the reciprocity theorem and the statistical summation of radio propagation, that two CYI values can be very close. Assume that the local noise is much less than the interference level and it can be neglected. So here we are not including the local noise. So generally the carrier to interference ratio, it is expressed with the, already I have shown it is, so here carrier is generally proportional to R power minus gamma, and C is equal to alpha into R power minus gamma. Here gamma is nothing but we are calling as propagation path loss slope. So interference, already I told, it is a summation of the 6 co-channel cells which come under the first tier. So here interference is nothing but the distance between the 6 co-channel cells which are coming under the first tier. So here in the mobile radio environment, the gamma value is assumed as, it is always gamma is 4 in the case of mobile environment. The path loss slope for the mobile environment is considered as 4. So Ki is the number of co-channel interference cells and it is equal to 6 in a fully developed system, as I have shown in the figure. So now we are substituting these values. So C by I is equal to R power minus gamma by summation of all the distances of the co-channel interference. 6 co-channel interference cells are there. No, we are summing, we will sum the distance of the 6 co-channel interference cells. So here we can bring this R to the denominator, then it will become dk by R whole power minus gamma. So we can write down in this way, C by I is equal to, we'll simplify, and already we know that d by r is a q. So here qk summation of minus gamma, where qk is the co-channel interference reduction factor with kth co-channel interfering cells. So qk is equal to dk by R. So it is a co-channel interference reduction factor, q is equal to d by R. So this is about the co-channel interference reduction factor. So in the next lecture, you will see desired C by I from a normal case in an omnidirectional antenna system. So what is the minimum carrier to interference ratio in the normal case of the omnidirectional antenna system? So what is the normal case? What is the omnidirectional antenna system? We will see in the next video. Thank you.